Good morning, Parkway. Wave at me. Yes, it's so good to see everybody here today. We're glad that everybody is joining us today, and glad that it is such a beautiful day, isn't it? It's a wonderful, beautiful day. Thank you to the council for praying away the rain. It's a beautiful, wonderful morning, and we're all here together for one reason. But before I talk about that reason, you're wondering why Denise isn't here. She isn't feeling well this morning, so you're stuck with me. But hopefully we'll survive it together. Hey, if you've got a neighbor in your car, turn to your neighbor and say, he's not nearly as good looking as she is.
He's not nearly as good looking as
she is. Hey, the reason that we're all here today is to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen? Amen. So let's begin our service with prayer. Father, we thank you for this beautiful day. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. This is the day that you have made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. We're going to enter into your gates with thanksgiving. We're going to enter into your courts with praise. We're going to lift up a sacrifice of praise to you, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks. Hallelujah. We bless you. We honor you. We magnify you. We lift you up. We exalt you. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. Hallelujah. And we lift up our hearts together today in praise and in worship. Father, we're going to sing from the depths of our heart, from the depths of our soul, from the depths of our spirit. We're going to worship you with all that is within us today. And thank you, Father, for giving us this beautiful day, this beautiful opportunity to praise you one more time. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah, we're gonna take this time that you've given us, and we're going to give it back to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's join together in singing together. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go. Through the calm and through the storm, oh no, you never let go. Every high and every low, oh no, you never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Hallelujah. Let's sing that again. We're singing, oh no, you never let go. Through the calm and through the storm, oh no, you never let go. Every high and every low, oh no, you never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Let's sing it one more time. Oh no, you never let go. Through the calm and through the storm, oh no, you never let go. Every high and every low, oh no, you never let go. Lord, you never let go of me. Lord, you never let go of me. Lord, you never let go of me. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just thinking this morning about Lamar and Chandra. They're right down here up front doing our live feed. And we had Chandra's dad's graveside service yesterday, and yet they're here this morning in the midst of their battles, in the midst of their storms, and they're praising God. Hallelujah. I think if they can do it, we can do it. Amen. Hallelujah. Would you stretch your hands towards them, and let's just lift up the Berry family at this time. Oh God, in Jesus' name, we pray for the Berry family in this time of difficulty, in this time of loss. Oh God, we know, hallelujah, where our hope is. We know in Jesus' name that for those who die in Christ, that there is a hope. Hallelujah. There is a hope. And we're planning on seeing Jim again. And so, Father, we're just praying for Chandler and Lamar right now, that you would wrap your arms of love around them and encourage them and comfort them and be with them. And, Father, comfort them in such a way that they will know that you are with them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord.
I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. Yes, you are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. Hallelujah. Let's raise.
raise our hands.
You are perfect in all of your ways. Yes, you are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us.
You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Hallelujah. It's who we are in Christ. He is a wonderful Father. Amen. Let's praise Him together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's just sing a song that we all know.
Amazing grace. How sweet the sound. That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days God's praise than when we first begun.
Now let's lift our hands and sing.
Praise God, praise God, praise God.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise God, praise God, praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God,
praise God. Hallelujah. Let's give Him praise. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Well, it is so wonderful to see everybody today, and we're so glad to have everybody here today. It's such a beautiful, wonderful day, a beautiful, wonderful beginning for our Memorial Day weekend. And I want to say a special thank you to Donnie and Karen Lay. They've already got a load loaded up, and they're headed to Kansas City right after church. But they're sticking around long enough for us to use the trailer for our parking lot service. Can we say thank you to Donnie and Carrie? Yes, these parking lot services have been wonderful. And this is going to be our last one for a while. So let me just thank everybody involved. Chandra, Lamar, Erica, all of our parking lot attendants, Chuck, our security, everybody who's been involved in putting together these parking lot services. Let's just tell them all how much we appreciate this. Yes. So next Sunday is our Welcome Back Sunday, Pentecost Sunday, our Welcome Back Sunday. And we're going to be implementing the opening of our facility under Phase 1 guidelines. So things are going to be a little bit different than when you were last in the building. All of our seating will be appropriately distanced from in family clusters, so you can still sit together with your families, but it's going to be separate from other people, and that's for your safety. And we're, all of our volunteers are going to be wearing masks, and we're going to be offering masks to anybody who comes in the building. You don't have to wear one, but that would be appropriate to keep everybody safe in the indoor environment. So it's going to be quite different than the church that you remember, but it's still going to be Parkway. We're still going to be open next Sunday, and I am happy about that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thing is, I'm going to miss these parking lot services with these honking horns. These are great amens. That's wonderful. And the flashing lights. I'm going to miss these. So I guess I'll have to get used to just having you guys amen instead. So you guys promise to say your amens real loud inside next week, okay? All right. Good. 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 As you all know, this is Memorial Day weekend, and Monday, of course, is when we officially celebrate Memorial Day. But I would like for us to pause for a moment of silence for all those who have given their lives serving our country on the front lines in our military. All of the family members that have lost a loved one in the conflicts of our nation in the past. Can we just pause for a moment of silence and remember them in the way that they so uniquely deserve it? Amen. So thankful for those who have given their lives guarding us, guarding our nation. And I also want to mention all of those who are either in the military or have been in the military, our veterans. I think it would be appropriate for us to honor those who are still on the front lines and have stood on the front lines for us. So, hey, let's make this a rousing recognition of all of our veterans. Let's go ahead and honk our horns and flash our lights. Amen. 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 That's a wonderful tribute. And it may be the first time ever that we've recognized our veterans by such a rowdy response, but I think that's appropriate. Amen. 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 Again, next week, we're going to open up our building for our service on Pentecost Sunday, but we're only going to be having our 10:30 a.m. service. We're not going to have our groups meeting at this time, our Sunday school classes meeting at this time. We're only going to have the 10:30 service. So I just wanted to let you all know that. We're going to be operating under Phase 1 probably for at least several weeks until the governor and or the president and or our church and pastors council says otherwise. So we're going to be operating under phase one for several weeks. So just the 10:30 a.m. service only. But it will be so good to see you all here next Sunday. All right. Let's go ahead and dive into the Word. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Way back when I was a little boy, I was in Miss Kaya's class in first grade. And I evidently made an impression on Miss Kaya. I didn't attend Princess Anne Elementary my kindergarten year. I was up in Salisbury, Maryland, and I was at a different school there. So I transferred when we moved down to Princess Anne, Maryland. I was at a new school, and I guess I was wanting to make an impression, and I think I may have made an impression, but it may have been a bigger splash than I intended, because my desk ended up right next to the teacher's desk, right in front of the classroom, right next to the chalkboard, and I was consistent with my track record. I think it stayed at next to the teacher's desk all the way from first grade through sixth grade. So you guys can't picture me being a problem child, but let me assure you that I can be when I want to be. And so so Miss Kaya kept me close and kept me under her thumb. And I distinctly remember one time when she was having to leave the classroom, she walked up to me, and this was before the days when corporal punishment was, you know, outlawed and so forth. So she walked up to me and she grabbed my ear. And she said, "Sit still. Don't get out of your seat until I get back." And she left the classroom, and I sat still. I had a little bit of the fear of God or the fear of Miss Kaya, one or the other, but I sat still knowing that I needed to sit still. But that was unusual for me, obviously, because I normally did not sit still, and I don't think Miss Kaya would have grabbed my ear and told me to sit still if she would have thought that I would have sat still without her telling me to sit still. Well, Jesus said the same thing right before he ascended into heaven. Let's look at Luke 24, verse 49. Luke 24, verse 49. Right before Jesus ascended, listen to what he said. "I will send out the promise of my Father on you, but you sit in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." Jesus said, "Sit still. Don't you get out of your seat. You sit still in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." Now, Jesus was offering a new set of clothes. They were different clothes than the disciples had been wearing. They are different clothes than perhaps you are wearing right now. These are power clothes. These are clothes that have been powered from on high. And Jesus was saying that there are no other clothes that are going to get you through your mission that I've called you to accomplish. So I want you to sit still until you are clothed with this new set of clothes. And this new set of clothes is, they are power clothes, and you're going to be clothed with power from on high. So Jesus said, I'm going to send you new clothes, and they are going to be delivered soon. But you have to wait on your new clothes. Kind of reminds me of when I was a little boy. I didn't really know what Levi's were until I got to high school, I don't think. I was clothed from the Sears and Roebuck catalog. Anybody can relate to that? Anybody remember the Sears and Roebuck catalogs? Yeah, and they had those husky pants, and they had the extra patch on the knees so that didn't wear them out quite as quickly. You know what I'm talking about. And I was clothed with Sears and Roebuck clothes. But this was before the internet. Sears and Roebuck were our internet. And so my mama would order from Sears and Roebuck, and then we would have to wait until our new clothes arrive. Well, I'm not very good at waiting, are you? I'm not very good. I'm not very patient at waiting. I'm not very good at sitting still. In fact, I can't really even stand still. I know I drive some of you crazy because I'm always rocking back and forth while I'm talking. I'm not good at being still. I'm not good at sitting still. I'm not good at waiting around. But this is what Jesus said in Acts chapter 1, verse 4, right before he ascended into heaven. He had commanded them to not leave Jerusalem, but to wait. 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 In fact, the word is the word wait with the Greek word peri in front of it. And that's where we get perimeter. And so this word literally means to wait around. You're going to have to wait around. He said, don't leave Jerusalem, but wait around for the promise of the Father, which you have heard me speak about. I'm not good at waiting around. But that was Jesus' command. And they were obedient. Listen to what it says in Acts chapter 1, verses 12 and 13. Then they returned to Jerusalem, and they went up into the upper room where they were waiting. Waiting. And this word is the word wait with the word kata in front of it. So it means they're waiting together. They're waiting together. Now, I would rather wait alone than wait together. Can we be honest? Because people sometimes get on my nerves. Did I just say that out loud? You know what I'm talking about. People, hey, thank you for that amen. Yeah, people, you know, when you're having to wait around with people, sometimes they want to act up. Sometimes they want to pitch a fit. You know, sometimes they get hangry. Anybody ever gotten hangry? You know what I'm talking about? Hungry and angry at the same time. And so when you wait around by yourself, you can handle yourself more. But when you're waiting around with people, people can get on your nerves, can't they? But these disciples must have remembered what it says in Isaiah 40, verse 31. They that wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. Hallelujah. How many of you desire that waiting on the Lord to be strengthened and encouraged by the Lord? Hallelujah. So the disciples waited. They were obedient. And they waited. In fact, the very next verse of Acts chapter 1, verse 14 says, they all were continuing. They were continuing. They were waiting. But then it adds that they were continuing in prayer. They were continuing in prayer. And then it adds, they were continuing in prayer with one mind. With one mind. Continuing in prayer with one mind. Wow. Wow. So they were not just waiting, but they were waiting together. And they were not just waiting together, but they were continuing in prayer with one mind. I'm reminded of what I've had to tell several families and what I often tell myself. And that is that every day is a gift. Every day is a gift. When you've faced life-threatening circumstances like me and like some of you, you begin to realize that every day is a gift. And you ought to treat that day as a gift from God. We ought to live every day as though it were going to be our last. We ought to live every day in light of eternity. We ought to get right with God, and we ought to get right with others. We should let nothing remain outstanding for this day, because this day could be our last. Well, Pastor, that's kind of morbid. Do you live your life in that way? Yeah, I kind of do. I wake up every day and I thank God. Thank you, Father, for this another day of life and breath that you've given to me. Thank you, Father. And I want to use this day for your glory and for your honor. And if it's my last day, how many of you all remember when you were little kids and you knelt down by your bedside and you prayed, "Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take." You know what? I still pray that prayer at nighttime. I still pray that prayer. Well, that's just morbid, Pastor. You're always thinking about death. Well, hey, we ought to celebrate the life that God has given to us. We should not take for granted a single breath, a single second, a single hour, a single day. It's a gift from God. Hallelujah. So I think that while the disciples were continuing in prayer with one mind, I think that they were getting closer to God. I think that they were getting right with God. I think that Peter probably, I'm going to use my imagination. Is that all right? I'm going to take a little break and use my imagination right now. I think Peter probably apologized to the disciples for forsaking them and abandoning them. And I think they all apologized to each other for forsaking each other during the crucifixion time. I think they got right with God. I think they got right with each other. And I think that they would not let anything remain outstanding. Why? Because in the very next verse, verse 15, it says that they replaced Judas with Mattathias. So in other words, while they were continuing in prayer with one mind, the Lord must have put His finger on their hearts and told them that something remained outstanding and it needed to be addressed. Oh, Father, can we open up our hearts to You and allow You to put Your finger on our hearts and show us anything that remains outstanding, anything that needs to be addressed that we have not addressed. Anything for better or for worse, oh God, put your hand upon our hearts and show us what we need to do or what we need to stop doing so that we can be right with you, so that we can be right with one another, and so that nothing can remain outstanding. Amen. So this is what happened during the 10 days before Pentecost. After Jesus ascended into heaven, 10 days later, the day of Pentecost was coming. And that's what happened during these 10 days. They continued in prayer with one mind. They waited together. They waited around. They sat in the city. They sat still. And then, suddenly, on the day of Pentecost, they were all together in one mind and in one accord. In fact, what it says literally in that first verse of chapter 2, when the day of Pentecost came, they were all together. But it says that in two different ways in the same sentence. It uses the word that we use for homogeneous. They were all the same. They were all together. But then it says together again. So it says they were all together, together. Now, why did Luke write this in this way? Because I think he knew that there's a difference between being together and being together, together. Amen? And so they weren't just together. They weren't just in one room. They were in one mind and in one accord. In fact, it literally says they were on the same. And how would we fill in that blank with our American English language right now? On the same page. So they were together. This is the Philip Morris version. They were together on the same page. Amen. And then suddenly, there was a sound out of heaven, as if it were being carried by a violent wind. And it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Wow. When the Holy Spirit was poured out on the day of Pentecost, the disciples were still being obedient to Jesus' command. Sit in the city until you're clothed with power from on high. Jesus had commanded them to sit still. And then on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came, they were all sitting. They were all sitting still. Wow. What an environment. An environment of obedience. An environment of unity. An environment of togetherness. An environment of love. An environment of expectancy. Oh, I would love if next Sunday morning, hallelujah, that we would all show up in a spirit of obedience and a spirit of unity and in a spirit of togetherness, in a spirit of love, in a spirit of expectancy. Hallelujah. And then in verse 3, there appeared to them divided tongues like fire. And it sat on each one of them. Wow. Did you hear that? It sat on the ones who were sitting. It sat on the ones who were being obedient. It sat on the ones who were waiting on the Lord. it sat upon those who were being still and knowing that He is God. Hallelujah. It sat on those who weren't worked up in a frenzy. They weren't pacing nervously. They weren't sleeping lazily. They weren't out on the town getting drunk. They weren't in doubt or despair. They were waiting expectantly, sitting on the edge of their seats for the Holy Spirit to show up. Hallelujah. And then it happened. Hallelujah. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Oh, don't you know that Jesus gets tired of chasing us down like a moving target? He gets tired of chasing us down like a moving target. When He told us to sit and we don't sit, and then we wonder why we're not receiving the blessings of God, when we're not walking in that obedience. But when we are walking in that obedience, and we are walking together with Him, then we can all be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And then they began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them what to speak out. Hallelujah. So they were all filled. It doesn't say some were filled. They were all filled. Praise the Lord. Why did that happen? I think that was because they all were continuing in prayer with one mind together. Hallelujah. They were all in the same mind. They were all on the same page. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then the people gathered around and wondered what was going on. And Acts chapter 2 verse 14 says, "Then Peter stood up with the 11, lifted up his voice, and spoke out to them." Oh God, help us to know when it is time to sit down and shut up. And help us to know when it is time to stand up and speak out. Oh God, help us to have a sensitivity to the Holy Spirit of God. Help us to not walk in the flesh. Help us to not try to fulfill some good intentions in an ungodly way. Help us to be patient. Help us to sit when we're supposed to sit, and to stand up and speak out when we're supposed to stand up and speak out. Amen. Amen. So, 10 days of quarantine. Sound familiar? 10 days of quarantine. After Jesus ascended into heaven, they were told to sit. Sit in the city. 10 days of sitting still. 10 days of waiting around. 10 days of praying. 10 days of obedience. 10 days of getting right with God. 10 days of getting right with others. 10 days of leaving nothing undone. 10 days of getting into alignment with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. 10 days of drawing near to Him and preparing for Him to draw near to us. Oh, church, could we take some time this week, leading up to next Sunday, Pentecost Sunday, could we take some time this week to sit still? To sit still in the presence of God. To have a time of introspection. To ask what we need to change about our lives. To draw closer to God. But you can't draw closer to God without drawing closer to your brother. You can't love God and hate your brother. You've got to love God and love your brother at the same time. Hallelujah. You've got to get things right with God. You've got to get things right with other people. Oh, church, what if this week we had some time to sit still? What if we this week had some time to wait around? What if this week we had some time to wait together? What if this week we had some time to continue in prayer? What if we had some time this week to continue in prayer with one mind? Hallelujah. How about some time this week when we could get together in one mind and one accord? Hallelujah. And be on the same page together. Hallelujah. How about some time this week for us to sit still? I feel some conviction right now. I'm preaching myself under conviction because I'm not good at sitting still. But sitting still is being obedient to God. Be still and know that I am God. Amen. And Isaiah 40, verse 31 again. They that wait upon Yahweh will renew their strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. And the old song said, teach me, Lord. Teach me, Lord, to wait. Can we wait upon the Lord this week? Can we wait upon the Lord in our quiet times this week? Can we stop giving Him our laundry list of everything that we want for just a little while and sit still and listen to His voice? Oh God, open my ears to hear Your voice. Open my eyes to see Your face. Open my mouth to receive Your Holy Spirit, for you've given us all one Spirit to drink. Oh God, help me, God, to sit still in Your presence, to wait upon You, because when You show up in Your glory and in Your power, nothing will ever be the same. Amen. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we repent for working ourselves up into a frenzy instead of sitting still. For pacing nervously instead of sleeping, instead of sitting still. Oh Father, we repent for sleeping lazily instead of sitting still in Your presence. Oh Father, we repent for being out on the town when we're supposed to be sitting still. Oh Father, we repent for being in doubt and despair instead of sitting still on the edge of our seats, resting in Christ, abiding in Christ, dwelling in Christ. Oh God, oh God, this week, this coming week, leading up to Pentecost Sunday, help us to sit still in Your presence. Help us to wait around in Your presence. Help us to continue in prayer in Your presence. Help us to continue in obedience in Your presence. Help us to get right with you, oh God. Help us to get right with everybody else, oh God. Help us to not leave anything outstanding, anything undone. Oh God, when you put your finger on something, help us to listen, to wake up, and to address those things that you want addressed. Oh Father, help us this week to get into alignment with you, oh God. Help us to draw near to you. And you have promised that you will draw near to us. And then, Father, next Sunday, as we come together expectantly online and inside our building, oh, Father, we're asking for an outpouring of your Holy Spirit. We're asking for you to manifest your presence in a mighty and wonderful way. Oh God, we're asking, Father, that you would fill us all with your Holy Spirit afresh and anew. Oh God, we're asking in Jesus' name that we would be receptive, that we would receive the Holy Spirit. Oh God, in Jesus' name, help us to drink in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Father, on Sunday, Pentecost Sunday, next Sunday, Father, in Jesus' name, let us come and drink from the well, the water of salvation, the well of your Holy Spirit. Help us to be refreshed in your presence. But Father, this week, help us to sit still, to be still, and know that you are God. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give God all the praise and all the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, it's been wonderful to be with you today. Everybody joining online and everybody in the parking lot, everybody on the conference call. It's been wonderful to be together today. And I'm just going to give you a few instructions before dismissing you. If you will please exit through this exit right here. And for those that would desire to give their tithes and offerings, there's touch-free giving available where you could just drop it in the bag, drop it in the bucket as you go by. If you want to do that today, we're so thankful for your faithfulness in giving. And I'm going to ask that you be dismissed in rows. So this first row, go first, and then just so we don't have any collisions in the parking lot. Amen. Amen. And so let me encourage you to join us this Wednesday night online for our Bible study at 6:30. It's a wonderful study. We're starting a study on worship. And what better topic to get us ready for Pentecost Sunday than the topic of worship. So join us this Wednesday night at 6:30 online. Amen. God bless you. Let's be dismissed with the blessing of the Lord. Why don't you just reach out your hands and receive this blessing from the Lord this morning. Yahweh bless you and keep you. Yahweh make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. Yahweh lift up His countenance upon you and give you shalom, give you peace. Amen. God bless you. I love you, Parkway. See you next Sunday. Shalom.